Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining me here on WMUR's Weather on the Web. I'm meteorologist Bill Guile. Here's your forecast for your Sunday night. And we noticed during the course of the day on Sunday itself that the dew point temperature began to rise today. It was climbing through the low 60s this morning and making its way to the mid and upper 60s for the overnight. So it's starting to get very sticky out there. And it's going to stay that way for the next couple of days. In fact, the dew point is going to be hovering right around 70 degrees for Monday and Tuesday. And with all that moisture in the air, there is certainly going to be the threat for showers and thunderstorms to be developing. Now, we did have temperatures during the day on Sunday topping off well into the 80s. It's still warm into the evening hours. In fact, the nation's midsection was really heating up. And how about down in Dallas, Texas, 100 degrees for today. So we take a look what's happening with the weather systems. We put on the satellite and the radar imagery. You can see this well-defined area of moisture that's working its way into the northeast, while the rest of the country relatively quiet for Sunday afternoon and into the evening hours. And for the most part, things will stay that way over the next 24 hours. It'll be the scattered storminess, but we'll be the focal point here in the northeast, having to deal with some unsettled conditions as area of low pressure is now working into the northeast, and a couple of fronts will be sliding in. Essentially, this first one is just going to basically fade away. The second one kind of comes in and stalls for a little while, and that's going to be the conduit for moisture to come up the coastline. So let's take a little closer look at what's happening through the evening hours of your Sunday night. Some shower activity. That's pretty much all that made it into New England from the late afternoon hours from New York State. And most of this will be dying down during the course of the overnight hours and passing on by as this first frontal system itself begins to fade away. So this shower activity for the first half of the night is what I'm expecting. In fact, as we get towards the midnight hour, 1, 2 o'clock in the morning, most all this activity is going to be diminishing and some of the clouds breaking up. So overnight lows, 61 to 65 degrees up north, 60 to 69 in southern areas. And again, a little bit muggy out there for sleeping for tonight. Next couple of nights are going to be a little tough nights for sleeping. You're going to certainly want some air conditioning, that's for sure. Now, during the day on Monday, it looks like we start out basically dry. Clouds will build for the afternoon. There will be a scattered shower or perhaps thunderstorms beginning to form mid to late afternoon with high temperatures up north, upper 70s, low 80s. It'll reach 80 to 85 in southern areas. It's going to be a muggy day, so remember that. So a scattered shower or thunderstorm in particular could pop up at any point in time, especially as we get towards the late afternoon and evening hours. You'll see the clouds building for a while. That could yield a shower or thunderstorm. Now, there will be a much greater risk on Tuesday for thunderstorm development. Again, we're still in the very juicy air mass. Temperatures 77 to 83. Don't expect as much sunshine Tuesday as we should see on Monday, and certainly a lot more moisture coming in. Now, the yellows and orange, those could be indicative of thunderstorm development and some heavy downpours embedded within that'll be sliding through the region. And we'll be seeing that lasting into Tuesday evening. And then the wave, you can see, slowly works its way, this whole frontal system taking a couple of days to just get off the coastline. So we'll be drying out on Wednesday. In the morning hours, we'll see southeastern New Hampshire lingering with some showers, while improvement will be coming in from the north and west later in the day. Temperatures will be cooler on Wednesday, though, settling back between 72 and 79 degrees, but we're starting to lose the mugginess. Now, a few tips to keep in mind about thunderstorm activity, especially on Tuesday. Any of the storms capable of producing some heavy downpours, which could result in flash flooding on the streets. So in the poor drainage areas, you need to keep an eye out for that. Could also produce some gusty winds that would reach 35, maybe 50 miles per hour, even the possibility of hail. That greatest risk is on Tuesday, but certainly it could happen with any thunderstorm development that does occur. Here's the five-day forecast for you as we look ahead. Again, muggy for tomorrow, muggy for Tuesday, with temperatures low 80s for the most part. It starts drying out Wednesday, turns cooler. That's actually our transition day back to less humid air and more comfortable conditions, so that Thursday and Friday are looking quite nice as the sunshine returns in earnest with a good deal of comfortable temperatures reaching the low and mid-80s. That's your latest forecast. Have a great week, everyone.